Goodbye to the good vibes. What we thought were the best times. Nights out with the people I love. Now I'm lost in the neighborhood. They raised me, praised me, made me who I am. My father was twice the man. And now that pain's resurfacing. Brooklyn don't feel the same. Maybe I'm the one who changed or the one to blame. Another dream down the drain and 10 more before I get on that plane. I swear.
Hey guys, it's Paige at Fireside, and today marks the first official Reptile Room tour of my YouTube channel. So sit back, relax, grab some popcorn and ice cream, and let's get started. So this is my first official snake I've ever had. Had him since 2015. I worked with snakes prior to that at the local shop, and I bless the owner's heart. I went there every single day, and I just bugged the crap out of them. What's this snake? What does it do? What does it eat? Where is it from? You name it, you name the question, I asked it. So this guy, Sagani, this was the snake actually featured in my What to Do with Snake Mites video. Not one of my proudest moments, but I'm happy to say he's fine now. He started eating again and the mites are gone. So that was a close call. I don't have anything to worry about. I got Sagani when I was going through a really tough time in my life and I just was really looking for something to be proud of, and he was definitely it, and he still is. My mom was actually diagnosed with breast cancer, and we were moving, and I just felt like I don't want to be in a big house all alone. I had the horse, yes, man. I just felt like snakes kind of gave me a sense of peace and like, hey, it's all gonna be fine. And he did that job better than any company I could have had. He did that. So he kind of had a rough patch there, just like I did, but I think that's why we became such good friends, and he is just like puppy dog tame. He's just the nicest snake ever, and recently, since I realized, man, this snake means a lot to me, I started taking the big normal, who you'll see next, instead of him, because I'm like, if someone walks by and sees him and knows how much he's worth, they're gonna grab him off my shoulders and run, and I can't have that. He's my little healer. I love him to death. This monstrosity is Rakoti. I got him as a rescue. What I understand is that someone had him, their daughter went off to college, and he was a cute little baby snake when she got him. And then eventually, he wasn't so cute anymore because he got big and he started to bite. Oh yeah, he's a killer. He's definitely a biter. So the guy wound up bringing him into the shop and dumped him off on the counter and took off. And Cody stayed at the shop for a while before I really came in and said, I want this snake, I can't let him sit here and die. So from what I understand, he had some sort of, now here's the miscommunication. I didn't understand if it was shed skin that came like a rubber band, or they actually did tie a rubber band around his mouth, because he had a rubber band tied around his mouth to avoid biting. And it was very prominent on his face at the time. He kind of had like the black pastel mouth where it was like a duck mouth almost. It was really sickening to me because I got Sakani and I started rescuing other animals because I'm like, oh, snakes, I love them. And then this guy came along, and at the time he was the biggest snake I had. So Rakoti means record in Swahili, because he was my biggest snake. And honestly, he's probably, between he and Sakani, I know it's not right to pick favorites because these are like my children, but these two are my favorite. You can't beat them. They're just the nicest snakes ever, and he's just gotten to be such a huge part of my life. My parents even love him, and they're afraid of snakes. Well, they were afraid of snakes. But he's puppy dog tame. Literally, he's probably more tame than Sagani is. You can pet him on the head. He's a love bug, and he's my one now that I take. If I need to go to a show, if I need to go do a birthday for a friend or something, I take him because it's like, what? He's big! But he's also the tamest thing ever, you know? My little tiny pastel I'll show later. She's the tiniest little thing on the planet. She'll take your arm off. She's crazy. So when you see Rakoti, you kind of think, wow, big snake. If you don't know about ball pythons, obviously, you're kind of like, that's a big old snake. He's the one I lift his mouth up and I show people his teeth. When they want to see what snake teeth looks like, I show him. When I got him, he actually he sat in his water bowl for like 3 weeks, and it wasn't mites, because I had him quarantined and checked and sprayed and you name it. He was so dehydrated. He was like a wet Stater Brothers bag in the ocean. He was so flappy and hungry and dehydrated, and it was like, he just looked so dull and sick. So of course, who better than me to come slithering to for help, because I'm like, oh, poor baby. I cleared out a whole thing in my reptile room at the time, and I made Rakoti a little palace, and now he's in the big tank over there, which is 50 gallon high, so he's got some room. He's a runner. He likes to all over the place. So he enjoys that, and believe it or not, that's a kitty litter box as his hide, because he wouldn't fit into anything else. So I had to get a kitty litter box and cut some holes in it for a hide for him. I'm so happy the progress that he's made. So hopefully we'll see more of him in the future in some of my getting people over their fear of snakes videos, because he's the one to do it with. This girl right here is Hatari. She's my little female low white hide. I got her from Howard Leong at HC Premium Reptiles at the recent Pomona show, actually. So she's my little 2018-2019 baby. And oh my god, I love her to death already. I can't believe how much I would get attached to a little tiny baby like this again, like I did with Sagani. But she's my sassy little girl. And oh my god, she's a good eater too. She is crazy. Like, she'll take your arm off too. But once you get her out, she's great. She hasn't struck at me yet. No promises. I like her little mouth. I don't know if you can see. You can see definitely on my pictures on Instagram of her. You can see her little spots on her lips. She has the cutest little spots on her lips. It looks like a little tiny mustache. Look how pretty that is. Little snake sausage. Hi! Her little ring around her tail. That's the only white on her back that you can find, but she's gonna be a powerhouse mama. I can't wait. Hopefully she's gonna be the next Elvira at Porter's Pythons. No, I'm kidding. You can't beat her. This boy is Donato. His name means gift from God in Italian, my native language. Because I thought, what a gift that someone found me. He was lost in someone's car for, I wanna say 3 months, for the whole winter season. He was lost in someone's car, starving and cold and with a severe respiratory infection. And oh my god, I'm so happy that I found him when I did. He was like a saggy, he still is a little flappy, but he's going in the shed and he's been eating like nuts. Oh my god, I'm so happy he's been eating, because he was just starting to kind of look like not so good. So he was a rescue mission. Boy, I actually have him in the hot box. I'll show you guys later the hot box. It's like it's enclosed, it's made of wood, so it's super toasty in there, and he stays real warm. So that definitely killed the respiratory infection, because nothing can survive in that box besides a snake. This is Amani. I got her from, I don't remember his name. He's at TS Reptiles. I love this snake already. I named her Amani because I believe that means peace in Swahili. And she is just like, she has such a graceful little face. I just love her. She's gonna be a fun one to work with. She is a pewter. And from what I understand from a few of the breeders I've spoken to, this stripe down her back is looking a little promising for me. So I don't know what else she's got, but I can't wait to find out. Gonna be pairing her with a snake from a buddy of mine, actually. And the secret pairing, it's the secret pairing. I can't wait. It's gonna be a little while down the road, but I'm still pumped about it, because according to the Morph Market genetic calculator, there's something in there that may not have been bred yet. There is not an option for it. So I'm like, ooh, if the snake gods will please breathe on me and give me something awesome, that would be great. Oh, she's also het pied, so that's another little hint. But if this stripe means anything, down her center, I've never really seen a pewter online that has that real prominent stripe down their back. So I'm excited about that. And so keep in touch here. Stay tuned, because I don't know what I'm gonna make here. I don't know what I'm gonna make. I'm just excited to make it. Isn't that all of us in the ball python community? Okay, this is one of my piss and vinegar snakes. I don't know what happened to her when she was born, but she's like psycho. And she's like the only ball python that I own besides her sister that will literally go for the eyes. Like, she's crazy. This is Tazama. She's a pastel het pied, nothing fancy. Her eyes are gorgeous. She's a beautiful snake. She'll strike at anything that moves. So yeah, fantastic eater. Gonna be a great breeder if she keeps eating like this. Like, she's shot up. Her birthday was October and she has bulked up, as well as her sister, who's actually gonna be going to her new home soon, hopefully. Gotta work out the details. But she's an interesting little thing. Nothing much to say about her besides the fact that she has a very big appetite for humans sometimes, which is really not the best thing when you're trying to get people over their fear of snakes. Hi, yes, this is my baby ball python. She eats people. So I'm gonna leave that to the big guy. I'm gonna leave socializing to Rakoti.
So I don't really want to take her out since she's in blue right now. So that's okay, I don't want to make her upset, but she's sitting here in the corner being pouty and cute. Look at that little duck face. This is Tazama's sister, Mishika. She's the smaller and younger of the two, and she's also the one that'll be going to her new home soon. So revel in her glory before she bites the camera.
Excuse me, sir, what are you doing? Your house is there. You should probably go back in there.
Hallelujah, the problem child.
Well, if you follow me on Instagram, then you definitely know who this is. This is Nioka, and this is my female snake that I bought as a female that is most likely a male. Now, listen, I bought her 2015 from a not-so-reputable breeder. That was another flaw. I started into the ball python community in 2015. I've been working with snakes since I was like 13 or 14, but I never really got one until 2015. So I didn't really know a lot about which breeders were good and which breeders weren't. And unfortunately, I got this girl from a breeder that really wasn't that great. And of course, at the time, Mojave Pieds were the thing to make. So I got a female Mojave Het Pied to go with Sakani. And unfortunately, I have taken her to the vet more often than I'd like to admit. I have the vet bills over there in a stack of times that I've had to take her in and get other advice. All I know is that last time I took her in, they probed her and they popped her, and it's a boy. The size of the hooks, the length of the tail, I wasn't surprised, and then I saw hemipenes and I was like, and they said, relax, it could possibly be caudal glands. Watch who you buy from, just letting you know. This is Dania. She's my little teeny tiny graveler yellow belly het pied girl that I got from Sterling Nelson at the last reptile show in Pomona. She's so tiny. She wouldn't eat. Yesterday was the first day that she actually took down a rat on her own. I'm such a proud mother because I was so worried that like, what's wrong with her? What's gonna happen? Don't worry, she's eating. I'm super happy. I don't know what her deal was, but she's in a rack like the rest of them. She just didn't want to eat, so that's okay. Gorgeous little ringer on her butt right there. I just love it. So once she starts getting her strength back and growing a little bit more, I will be doing some photos of her just to show her off a little. Just a little nervous, but that's okay. Aren't we all? This little tiny baby is a chondro. That means banana in Malagasy, whatever. It's a language. And he's a big leap for me. This one was something new for me because I've always stayed away from spiders. Recently with the events, as you know, on YouTube with all the Brian Barchett crap and with New England Reptile Distributors is actually who convinced me to take this guy in. And he was a snake belonging to a buddy of mine that had him, and the dad got it for him just to get it for him. And he's like, I don't like spiders either. And I kind of just saw that he wasn't being loved on as much as he probably deserved. So I thought, okay, welcome to Fireside then, right? So this little guy has taken down his first couple rats with me. I'm so happy he's eating. Oh my God, it's like the best feeling ever when a snake eats. He's so tiny. But this snake has like virtually no wobble. So New England Reptile Distributors is who convinced me to just go, you know what, I'll take him. Because now with all this stuff with spiders being taken from people, from what I understand, I'm like, no. So I thought I would keep him, even just as a pet. I don't care. I just want to make sure he's taken care of and he's not going to go to somebody who's going to, like, kill him, because this is such a big thing now, apparently. So either way, here he is. He's a good boy. He's eating, and he is a gorgeous snake. From the second I saw him, I'm like, man, I love him. He turns pink when he eats. I think that's really cute.
All right, we are going to go fishing for snakes. There she is. Oh, there's her tail. Come here, child. I have to show the world your prettiness. She's a little snappy, so just gonna pull her out and show you. There she is! This is my female stripe Kenyan Samboa.
putting some weight on. Super happy about that. Everybody always thinks she's kind of ugly, but I love her to death.
And here's my crazy man. The reason why he is in this jail is because the scales on his back are damaged. He is a Paradox Snow Kenyan Samboa, and until those scales heal, he will forever be in this little angry man jail. But he is another one that is just spazzy, crazy. He's the definition of why I like bigger snakes. He's bitten me more than my ball pythons have.
This is Miss Ghosty. She is the snake of the hour. I have been trying to prove out Scotty because every person I send pictures of him to has said that's not a normal pied. And I'm like, okay, well, we'll find out. So I'm borrowing Ghosty for a little while. I'm led to believe that she's a vanilla because she has a little head stamp and she's kind of an unusually gray color. So I don't think she's a normal, but we'll find out, right? So this is not only to prove out her, but to prove out him. I locked him up a few times and she just hasn't really shown me an ovulation, so I can't tell. We'll find out soon though, I'll keep you posted.
And in here I have Holokai, who is my extremely old male. What are you doing, dude? That looks inappropriate. This is my extremely old male crested gecko that I'm going to censor. That's disgusting. Okay, moving on. While he's licking his... It's amazing the luck of some people. Their gecko accidentally laid eggs in the water bowl and they hatched. I'm like, okay. Sure, I'll take them. So I don't know where this other one is, but this is one of them. I believe they're both tigers. They're not old enough to tell the sex yet, but they're looking great, so...
This girl right here, I just got in. She's a pink-toed tarantula. I think she's a female. I can't tell. Looks like a female to me.
In here, in the deepest depths of my jungle, we have Miss Hokulani, who came in with Holokai when I rescued both of them. Someone came into the vet's office, set the tank down, and ran out. So I took them both in, not understanding why, and I realize now why. She has never laid a good egg. She was the one that produced the two eggs that died, and prior to that, she never laid a fertile egg. So that, I think, is why they left them, because they weren't breeding well for them. And she's been in Fireside since. I can't find Big Chungus. I don't know where she is. She hides very, very well.
There she is. Hey, Chungus. Hey, girl. She likes to bite me. Hey, Mama. Hey, Big Chungus.
Her name is Makani, but I call her Big Chungus because she's like the fattest gecko I've ever owned in my life. I love her. She's like morbidly obese. These are all of my little tiny baby praying mantises. If you saw the last video, I had like 150 of them. I am now down to 8. I don't know what the heck happened. All those are empty. They were all set up the same. They all received the same amount of fruit flies, the same amount of water. I don't understand what happened. It literally was the same treatment for every single one of them. But some survived, some didn't. I have no explanation why. I'm not a bug expert. There's this one. I don't know if you can see.
There he is. He's chilling.
So they're such interesting little guys. I love them. I just don't understand why they all died. Hey, if any of you know anything about praying mantises that can explain to me why I have 8 left out of 150, that would be great. I would really appreciate that.
This little guy kind of doesn't like when I pick him up all that much. He's still a little skittish. This is Elon, which means snake.
Hi, baby.
Got a little heart on his nose. He was almost fed to an arboreal snake because the owner was desperate to feed him. So he threw the leopard gecko in there with him, and one of my friends goes, oh my god, he's got stick tail disease, because he's seen my other rescues with stick tail, and he's like, oh, he's got stick tail. Took him in. This kid eats amazing. I love how much he eats, and he's just like boomed in size. He's great.
This one here is one of the gecko horror stories that you never want to see. She actually has MBD. The owner was completely negligent and, to be honest, a horrible person to work with. Just accused me of everything and lied, and it was awful. So she actually wound up giving this gecko to me. Her legs were both broken and they have formed back crooked. The MBD was so severe she didn't want to open her mouth, so I was actually able to shoot some food into her with calcium, which is what's sprayed along her tank, is like the high vitamin, high calcium powder. I just sprinkled it everywhere, so hopefully she'd lick it up, which is why her tank looks so grungy and disgusting. But this is Kilo. That means crooked in, I believe, Vietnamese. She's such an interesting, hi, Beatty, hi. You coming out to say hi? But she's walking. Hi, Beatty, what are you doing? You coming out to say hi? Hi, beautiful. And her tail, oh, her tail has gotten so fat. I'm so happy. She definitely won't be a breeder. She's gonna be a resident for the rest of her life here. She's gonna be my pet because I can't bear to let her go now. She's come such a long way here that I gotta keep her.
She is a very vocal, very interesting little gecko. I actually got her from Reptile City in Texas, and they shipped her to me in an awkward looking envelope thing with no heat. So she has been soaking up the warmth here on her little heating pad, and I can't wait to see what she can do. Awesome little albino babies, huh?
Okay, and over here in the darkest corner of Fireside Reptiles, there's a corn cob covered in mouse poop that I just cleaned. Not bitter about it at all. These are my little mice. This here's Pepper with her nose in the camera. She's my breeder female and the mom to the two other mice that are in there. Hi, baby. And I might just lift up the camera, lift up the hide and show you.
I know, so scary.
So the lighter one here is Daisy, darker one's Willow. And those are Pepper's two babies with a dwarf, actually. He was a little dwarfy mouse. And I don't know. I put him in there to be a companion because I didn't think he would breed with her, and he did. Stupid me, mice breed.
Hi, honey. Hi.
These two do like to scream at me when I touch their tail, but they don't ever bite me. Happy about that.
Hi. Oh, don't bite.
It destroys her cage as soon as I clean it. It's Shecky. Not gonna lie, she was kind of an impulse buy. I had to have a hamster. I had to have a little Robo-Dwarf hamster because I just thought they were too cute. So yeah, that's where she came from. I actually decided to go on a walk, and I looked on my phone and I was like, oh, there's a Petco 2 miles away. That's not very long. So I walked 2 miles there to get her and 2 miles back. I'm like, I have a car. What am I doing? I just wanted a hamster. So that's Shecky.
So that concludes it. Thank you so much for watching. I appreciate all the support and all the encouragement and all the video recommendations. I love doing this. I just don't ever know what to do a video on, and I stutter a lot and I say stupid stuff. So doing videos is not really that fun sometimes. But thank you so much for hanging out and sticking with me through the video. I'm glad you guys got to kind of finally see all my animals in one spot. There will be more. I have just sold lots of snakes, so I'm kind of low in number right now, but there will be more. There's a lot of stuff going on, so I'm gonna keep you guys posted. It's kind of fun, it's kind of interesting to make little videos here and there on it. So thank you again for the encouragement, and I appreciate you hanging around for the whole video. See you next time.